Notable information last night, Isaiah Ford returns to training. Ahmed nominated for the award for his Week 15 performance. Linebacker Kamu Grugier-Hill put himself in a difficult position when did not report as an eligible receiver. And finally, injury updates: Mike Gesicki, Devontae Parker, Jakeem Grant and more. Here is the detailed information. Wide receiver Isaiah Ford obviously did enough in his return to the Miami Dolphins lineup to earn another look. The Dolphins announced Tuesday that Ford would be elevated from the practice squad for the Week 16 game against the Las Vegas Raiders as a COVID-19 replacement. Ford had 3 catches for 18 yards in the 22-12 victory against New England in his first game with the Dolphins since returning following his November 3 trade to those same Patriots. With Ford, the Dolphins have 6 wide receivers on the roster, though Devontae Parker and Jakeem Grant both are nursing hamstring injuries that caused them to miss the New England game. The move involving Ford was part of a busy day related to the practice squad. The Dolphins signed wide receiver Marcus Kemp to the practice squad Thursday, then proceeded to make him one of their 4 poaching protections. The other practice squad players protected from poaching have been regulars for this: tight end Chris Myerick, quarterback Reed Sinnott and long snapper Rex Sunahara. Kemp caught 2 passes for 27 games over 3 seasons with the Kansas City Chiefs, and his last game with that team was December 13, against the Dolphins. Ahmed up for award after Tua Tagovailoa's back-to-back Pepsi Zero Sugar NFL Rookie of the Week awards. Running back Salvin Ahmed will try to make it 3 in a row for the Dolphins. Ahmed was one of the 5 players nominated for the award for his Week 15 performance when he rushed for 122 yards and a touchdown in the 22-12 victory against New England. The other 4 nominees this week are Eagles quarterback and Tagovailoa's former Alabama teammate Jalen Hurts, Chargers quarterback Justin Herbert, Vikings wide receiver Justin Jefferson and Chiefs cornerback Lejarius Reed. Fans can vote for the award at NFL website. The winner will be announced later in the week. 3. Kamu comes forward. Linebacker Kamu Grugier-Hill has taken to Instagram to plead his case that his reception from Matt Hawk out of punt formation should not have been nullified because he failed to report as an eligible receiver. Grugier-Hill posted a picture of his 14-yard reception on 4th-and-7 from the New England 44-yard line that was called back after he was penalized for an illegal touch and being an ineligible man downfield. "I reported," Grugier-Hill wrote on Instagram, accompanied by the exasperated emoji. Tagovailoa replied, "Nice grab though," while his teammates on the punt team backed his story. Bobby McCain, Brandon Jones, Kevin Frazier and Blake Ferguson all backed Grugier-Hill's claim. "I'm a witness," Frazier posted. The Miami Dolphins conducted a walkthrough Tuesday when they began their on-field preparations for their game against the Las Vegas Raiders, so their first injury report of the week represented an estimation of who would have been available for a real practice. With that in mind, rookie guard Solomon Kindley was the only player listed as a non-participant. Kindley left the 22-12 victory against the New England Patriots on Sunday with a knee injury, and he's also listed on the injury report with a foot issue. Second-year player Michael Dieter replaced Kindley in the lineup against New England with veteran Eric Flowers, missing the game because of an ankle injury. Dieter starting at left guard against Las Vegas would be the likely scenario in the event both Kindley and Flowers can't play. Flowers was among the 9 players listed as limited participants Tuesday, along with the 3 offensive skill position players who missed the New England game: tight end Mike Gesicki, shoulder, and wide receivers Devontae Parker, hamstring, and Jakeem Grant, hamstring. Also listed as limited were safety Bobby McCain, ankle, and linebacker Kyle Van Noy, hip, who both played against New England after being listed as questionable Friday. It's worth noting that linebacker Alandon Roberts, who played against New England after being listed as questionable with a chest injury, was not on the injury report Tuesday. The same applied for rookie quarterback Tua Tagovailoa, who was on the injury report last week with an ankle injury and also appeared to turn his ankle when he took a sack against the Patriots. Others listed as limited Tuesday were LB Jerome Baker, knee, S. Clayton Fijidelum, thumb, and Deshaq Lawson, shoulder. Cornerback Xavien Howard, shoulder, and safety Kevin Frazier, shoulder, both were listed as full participants. For the Raiders, the big news obviously involves quarterback Derek Carr, and he was listed as a limited participant in practice Tuesday with the groin injury he sustained in Las Vegas 30-27 overtime loss against the Chargers on Thursday night. that Carr was able to practice at all suggests it's not a foregone conclusion that the Dolphins will be facing Marcus Mariota on Saturday night, as seemed inevitable at the time of the injury. Three Raiders players did not practice Tuesday, though two of the absences were not injury-related. The one that was involved defensive end Clelin Ferrell, the fourth overall pick in the 2019 NFL draft, and Christian Wilkins' teammate at Clemson, who has a shoulder injury. Some prominent players were limited in practice Tuesday besides Carr. Starting center Rodney Hudson, knee, back, safety Jonathan Abram, concussion, knee, starting guard Gabe Jackson, knee, and former Dolphins tackle Sam Young, knee. Former Dolphins linebacker Raekwon McMillan is on the injury report with an elbow injury, but he was a full participant in practice Tuesday.